Hello, I'm Jerry Goodspeed, and we're here at the Ogden Botanical Garden, and we're going to talk just a little bit about soil and soil testing. Soil is what we grow plants in. Dirt is what your kids track into the house, and you have to vacuum up. Plants grow really good in soil. They don't grow very good in dirt. And so we'll always refer to it as the soil. And the soil is the most important part of your plant. You have a good soil, you're going to have good plants. You have good soil, good roots, good plant. That's just the way it is. And so sometimes what we've got is an area like this where we want to start planting, and the only thing that really grows well here, well, is weeds. And we've tried to grow some plants in here before, and as you can kind of see, they're just not doing very well. We don't like that. So the first thing we're going to do is get a soil test. Now, this will help us eliminate a lot of problems, or at least try to narrow it down and see if there's some specific things we need to work on. So how do I get a soil test? Well, you can go to the Utah State University. We do have soil testing kits. They're free to pick up. The soil test itself is a minimal charge to get it done and sent off to the university. That's all pretty easy. But the hard part is, how do I know what soil to collect? And what soil is most important to sample? Well, we're going to go over that just real quick here. First thing we're going to do is we're going to measure out the plot. And so I measured it out. It's this big. So now what I'm going to do is just take samples randomly throughout this area, and I'm going to start throwing them into this green bucket. Now, I'm not going to need this much soil sample, but it's really good if I can take lots of different little soil samples, mix them up into here, and then I'll put them into my soil test, into this plastic bag right here, and slip them into the box. So originally, or eventually, that's all I need, but I'm going to start with a lot more than that. So let's dig some samples. Okay, so we're going to start digging, and a lot of questions are, how far down do I want my sample to be? Well, keep in mind a couple of things. One is you want it in the root zone. It's not going to do any good just to get this stuff right off of the surface. We're going to want it a little bit deeper, and so what I will do is I'll dig down about 4 to 6 inches and take off some of that top and just throw a little bit of that right into my sample. Not all of it. And this is just wonderful soil. Can you see how clay that is? Now, you might be around here digging, getting a sample, and all of a sudden you run into a place where your dog decided to leave a little deposit for you. We really don't want that in the soil sample. It's not going to help anything, and they're probably going to just throw it back to you. It's never good. So here we go. We're getting about 6 to 4 inches deep. A little bit in there. There's a couple other things we probably don't want in our soil sample as well. Rocks are never good. They're never good in any soil. Well, that's not true either. But we don't want them in the soil sample. So again, we're just trying to get down as deep as we can. Throw out some rocks. Get some of this soil down that's a little bit deeper. Throw it into my bucket. And I'm just randomly moving around. Anything from McDonald's you probably don't want either. We want to do this about 10 times. Take just different samples, about 6 to 4 inches deep. Okay, we've gone around and we've collected our samples. And we've got them in our bucket here. Now what we need to do is mix that up a little bit so that we get a really good, diverse sample. So I just take my shovel and I just stick it in there as best I can. Oh, that's wonderful soil. And whenever I hit a rock, I remember to throw it back out. So I'm just trying to mix this up to get a really good sample. Trying to break up some of the clods a little bit. Okay, that's pretty good. Now it's time to put it in our plastic bag. Okay, I had to go back and grab my soil sample kit. It blew away. So now I'm ready to put the soil into my box and into my plastic bag. And it's not going to take very much. You can see that this is really all I need. So what I do is figure out how to open it up. There we go. Now I'm going to fill this up. I usually just do that with my hand. And I've already mixed this up pretty good, so I don't have to worry too much about it. I just get a good sample in there. again, it doesn't take a tremendous amount of soil to get a good sample. So there we go. Now I've got my box. And usually what happens to me is I usually fill it too full. It won't even fit in the box. So I'll scrunch some of it down, make sure it's good in the box. Might have to skim off a little bit off the top because we're a little bit aggressive on the filling. There we go. Close it up. Write the sample number down if I've got more than one sample. Close up the box. Put my name and address on it. There'll be a little bit of paperwork that you also mail off. It's ready to go. That's easy.